Dear students, last class we were discussing about valence bond theory and overlapping of atomic orbitals. So we explained some molecules, the formation of a covalent bond was explained for certain molecules. For example, hydrogen fluoride, oxygen. So for all these molecules, covalent bond formation was explained. Today we start the hybridization. So according to valence bond theory, a covalent bond is formed due to mutual overlapping of orbitals, isn't it? So atomic orbitals with the single electrons are overlapping in a particular direction, so there is a formation of a covalent bond. Based on that, we explained covalent bond formation between two hydrogen atoms in H2 molecule or two fluorine atoms in F2 molecule, like that we explained. Consider methane molecule. Formula will be written as CH4. Right? Can we explain covalent bond formation between the carbon and the hydrogen in methane using the orbital overlapping? You will check. Consider carbon with atomic number 6, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2px1, 2py1. So carbon has two atomic orbitals with a single electron. What are they? 2px and 2py. But how much hydrogen atoms are coming to make a covalent bond? 4. So each hydrogen atom has a single electron in 1s orbital. So electronic configuration of hydrogen is 1s1. So there should be 4 overlapping, then only 4 covalent bond will be formed, isn't it? So between carbon and the hydrogen, there should be 4 covalent bond. Then only each atom will be stabilized by obeying octet rule. Around carbon there should be 8 electrons, and each hydrogen should have 8 electrons, 2 electrons around it. So when you take a methane molecule, when this will be stabilized, if 4 covalent bonds present around carbon, then it will be stabilized. But according to electronic configuration, we cannot explain the covalent bond formation. Why? For 4 overlapping, there should be 4 atomic orbital with a single electron. But carbon actually has 2 atomic orbital with a single electron. Only 2 overlapping is possible with the hydrogen. So 4 overlapping are not possible, so we cannot explain the covalent bond formation between the carbon and the hydrogen in methane molecule. So that we look forward some other theories like the concept hybridization. Okay. So what is the major aspect of valence bond theory, which deals with the overlapping of atomic orbitals with a single electron to form a covalent bond? So this is taking place in a particular direction, so that covalent bond formation as well as orbital overlapping is directional in nature. If 4 covalent bond is required, there should be 4 overlapping. In methane molecule, there should be 4 overlapping, then only the molecule will be stabilized. But due to less number of orbital with a single electron, we cannot explain the covalent bonding here. And using the instruments, so we already studied the bond parameters like bond length can be measured using some instruments like spectrometry or electron as well as X-ray diffraction techniques. So all these techniques as well as instruments can be used to measure the bond length. Right? So what we are expecting, that S orbital is overlapping with 1s orbital of hydrogen, means bond length will be different. If 2px orbital is overlapping with 1s orbital, it will have a different bond length. So this is our assumption, isn't it? So S orbital has a spherical shape. P orbital has a dumbbell shape. So structure will be different for both orbitals. If S orbital and S orbital are overlapping, there will be a particular bond length. P orbital and S orbital overlapping means bond length will be different. This is our assumption. But using the spectrometer instruments, X-ray and electron diffraction techniques, we found that the bond length in the methane molecule is equal. So 4 covalent bonds should be formed all the four covalent bonds are having equivalent bond length, which represents what? Ordinary overlapping will not be enough to explain the structure of methane. Okay, so just remind, what is valence bond theory? The theory which explains the formation of a covalent bond using orbital overlapping, point number one. Point number two, the orbital overlapping will take place in a particular direction, so they are directional in nature. Then for orbital overlapping, there should be a single electron for each orbital. Next, after forming a covalent bond, two electrons will be present in the bond or the overlapped orbital. We studied all these as salient features of valence bond theory. Based on these features, we try to explain the bonding in methane molecule, but we cannot explain based on orbital overlapping, because there should be four orbital with a single electron, then only it can make four covalent bond, because four hydrogen atoms are coming to make covalent bond. So since two atomic orbitals alone present in carbon with a single electron, four covalent bond formation cannot be explained. And we assume that if a covalent bond is formed between carbon and hydrogen, a different bond length will be possible. 2s orbital of carbon can overlap with 1s orbital of hydrogen. For example, you take this as first hydrogen. 1s orbital of hydrogen, 2s orbital of carbon overlaps, means there will be a particular bond length. If 2px orbital of carbon and 1s orbital of second hydrogen overlapping, means this bond length will be different. This is our assumption. But what practically happens? All the four covalent bonds are having equal bond length. This is observed by the spectrometry experiments, X-ray and electron diffraction patterns. So this says that along with orbital overlap, we need one more concept called hybridization. Okay. So here only we introduce a concept, hybridization. Hybridization is the process of intermixing of atomic orbitals of same atom. So within one atom, if atomic orbitals are intermixing, it produces a new orbital called hybridized orbital. So consider sp hybridization. We take beryllium chloride as an example. What about central atom beryllium? Beryllium has atomic number 4, 1s2, 2s2. So if chlorine atoms are approaching the beryllium, the electrons will be jumped from one energy level into another energy level, or one orbital into another orbital. So this is the ground state electronic configuration. So Gs represents ground state electronic configuration. Next, excited state configuration. That means if other atoms are approaching this beryllium, there will be a jumping of an electron. So one electron is jumped from 2s orbital into 2px orbital. So this is the excited state configuration of central atom beryllium. So we are going to explain the bond formation in beryllium chloride. Beryllium will make two covalent bonds with two chlorine atoms. This will be explained based on orbital overlapping and hybridization. So to understand the hybridization, we have taken this simple example, beryllium chloride. Beryllium is a central atom with atomic number 4. It has ground state configuration as 1s2, 2s2. Other atoms are approaching the beryllium, like a chlorine. In that case, an electron is jumped from s orbital into p orbital. From 2s orbital into 2px orbital, an electron is jumped. Then, two chlorine atoms are coming, isn't it? For chlorine, atomic number 17, configuration 1s2, 2s2. 2p6, 3s2, 3px2, 3py2, 3pz1. So this is the configuration of chlorine, right? So according to valence bond theory, what we will think? 2s orbital of beryllium will overlap with 3pz orbital of first chlorine. A covalent bond can be formed by overlapping. What is it? 2s orbital of beryllium and 3pz orbital of chlorine can overlap. There should be a formation of covalent bond. Like that, we assume. Next, 2p x orbital of beryllium will combine with 2p z orbital of one more chlorine. It forms a covalent bond. But what about bond length? Bond length will be different, isn't it? 2s and 3pz overlapping means this covalent bond. 2px and 3pz of another chlorine means this bond. Both will have different bond length. But according to the value which we obtained from the data, that means electron diffraction or X-ray diffraction data indicates that in molecule bond lengths are equal, which means we move into the concept called the hybridization. Directly atomic orbitals will not overlap, right? When you take these heteroatomic molecules, so in homoatomic molecule like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen fluoride, okay, direct overlapping between the atomic orbitals possible. So here when we consider heteroatomic molecules, more than two atoms present, so for these polyatomic molecules, before overlapping, direct overlapping is not possible. 2s of beryllium will not overlap with the 3pz of chlorine. Before that, there is a process called hybridization. It's called a hybridization. One s orbital and one p orbital of the same atom beryllium will intermix together to produce new orbital called sp orbital, sp hybridized orbital. Okay, so intermixing of atomic orbitals of same atom will produce new orbital called the hybridized orbital. This is called hybridization. The process of intermixing of atomic orbitals of same atom with approximately equal energy will give you new equivalent orbital called the hybridized orbital, and the process is known as hybridization. So two atomic orbitals with a single electron of beryllium will intermix together to produce new orbital called sp hybridized orbital. Number of hybridized orbital formed will be equal to number of atomic orbitals combined. So two atomic orbitals combined means we get two hybridized orbital. So the process is called what? Hybridization. Okay. So when you take beryllium chloride, atomic orbital of beryllium will not directly overlap with atomic orbital of chlorine. The same way this bond also, atomic orbital of beryllium will not directly overlap with atomic orbital of chlorine. Before that, there is a process called hybridization. 2s atomic orbital of beryllium, 2px atomic orbital of beryllium, 2px atomic orbital of beryllium will intermix together to produce equivalent new orbital called hybridized orbital. Due to the combination of s and p, the hybridized orbital is named as sp. So hybridized orbital has single electron. Now which will involve in bonding? This hybridized orbital. Okay, the hybridized orbital of beryllium will overlap with 3pz orbital of first chlorine. This sp hybridized orbital of beryllium will overlap with 3pz orbital of second chlorine. So there will be a covalent bond formation. So how these covalent bonds formed? Out of two sp hybridized orbital, one will overlap with 3pz orbital of chlorine because it has a single electron. So always orbital with a single electron will involve in covalent bond formation due to overlapping. So sp hybridized orbital of beryllium combines with 3pz orbital of chlorine. Due to overlapping, we get a covalent bond. In the same manner, one more sp hybridized orbital of beryllium is overlapping with 3pz orbital of chlorine with a single electron, it forms another covalent bond. So due to this type of overlapping only, both these two bonds are having same bond length. Okay, so equal bond length is obtained for a polyatomic molecule. This is mainly due to what? Hybridized orbital will overlap with the atomic orbitals of atoms, so that only we get equal bond length. Instead of hybridization, if directly 2s is overlapping with 3pz, means this will have different bond length. 2px will overlap with 3pz, means this will have different bond length. To avoid that, intermixing of atomic orbital takes place to give equivalent orbital, equivalent new sp hybridized orbital formed, so that we get equal bond length. So this is central atom beryllium. This is a structure of 2 sp hybridized orbital. How much sp hybridized orbital formed? 2. So this is the structure of 2 sp hybridized orbital. Each hybridized orbital has single electron. Now left hand side on chlorine atom as well as right hand side on chlorine atom, going to make a covalent bond. So we take, this is chlorine, first chlorine. The chlorine has a single electron in 3pz orbital, isn't it? This is sp hybridized orbital. This is 3pz orbital with a single electron. Second chlorine atom, this is 3pz. So, due to hybridization, the central atom beryllium has 2 sp hybridized orbital and each chlorine has a single electron in 3pz orbital. So due to head on overlapping between the beryllium and the chlorine, we have two covalent bonds, right? So this is called sp hybridization, and the angle between the bond are 180 degrees. So what will be the geometry? Linear. Linear will be the geometry. Next one, sp2 hybridization. We take boron trifluoride as an example. Boron with atomic number 5, ground state electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2px1. So when 3 fluorine atoms are approaching the boron, electrons will be jumped from one orbital into another orbital. So this is called the excited state configuration. 2s1, 2px1, 2py1. Why an electron is jumped from 2s into 2py? Because we need 3 orbital with a single electron. Then only 3 overlapping will be possible with the 3 fluorine atoms. So we need 3 covalent bond between the boron and the fluorine. So we need 3 orbital with a single electron, so that one electron is jumped from 2s into 2py. So in the excited state, we have 3 orbital with a single electron. Direct overlapping is not possible with fluorine. Before that, there will be a process called the hybridization. Then only we will get equivalent orbital to have equal bond length. So 1s and 2p orbitals are intermixing together to produce what? sp2 hybridized orbital. So 3 atomic orbitals with a single electron will intermix together to produce 3 sp2 hybridized orbital with a single electron. sp2 hybridized orbital of boron will overlap with atomic orbital of fluorine, then only bond length will be equal. So what about electronic configuration of fluorine? 1s2, 2s2, 2px2, 2py2, 2pz1. This is electronic configuration of fluorine. Only one orbital has a single electron. So this will involve in overlapping, that means bonding. So this is the hybridized orbital of central atom boron, this is the geometry of 3 sp2 hybridized orbital. Totally how much sp2 hybridized orbital will be formed? 3, because totally 3 atomic orbitals are intermixing. It forms 3 sp2 hybridized orbital. Each sp2 hybridized orbital will have a single electron. Now 3 fluorine atoms are coming. So 2pz orbital of fluorine, 2pz orbital of fluorine, 2pz orbital of fluorine. So direct overlapping between the sp2 hybridized orbital with 2pz orbital of fluorine will make boron trifluoride structure. So this is trigonal planar, sp2 hybridization at trigonal planar, bond angle 120 degree. So all the 4 atoms will be in the planar, so all these will be in one planar. So this is sp2 hybridization. Next, sp3 hybridization. Example, methane, carbon has atomic number 6, ground state configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2px1, 2py1. We need 4 orbital with a single electron because 4 hydrogen atoms are coming to make a covalent bond. So if hydrogen atoms are approaching the central atom carbon, an electron will be jumped from 2s into 2pz. So excited state configuration becomes 1s2, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1. 2pz1. Now to have an equivalent bond length in the molecule, that should be equal bond length. So direct overlapping is not possible. So there is a process called the hybridization. 1s and 3p orbitals are intermixing together to produce sp3 hybridized orbital. Totally 4 sp3 hybridized orbital will be formed. Right? 4 atomic orbitals are combining. So there will be 4 sp3 hybridized orbital will be formed. What about hydrogen? Has atomic number 1, electronic configuration 1s1. So what will be the overlapping? Sp3 hybridized orbital of carbon will overlap with 1s orbital of hydrogen. Both are having single electron. Direct overlapping will make sigma type of bond. So this is central atom carbon. This is the structure of 4 sp3 hybridized orbital. There are 4 single electrons. Each hybridized orbital has a single electron. Now 1s orbital of hydrogen has 1s orbital with a single electron. So direct overlapping between the s orbital of a hydrogen and the sp3 hybridized orbital of carbon will make 4 covalent bonds around carbon. So this is the structure of methane. So bond angle 109 degree 28 minutes. So this is called tetrahedral nature. The structure of a molecule with sp3 hybridization is tetrahedral. Sp linear, sp2 trigonal planar, sp3 tetrahedral. So all these are one mark, including bond angle. Next one, sp3d. For sp3d hybridization, we take phosphorus pentachloride as an example. Phosphorus atomic number 15, ground state configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3px1, 3py1, 3pz1. 5 chlorine atoms are going to make 5 covalent bonds. So we need 5 atomic orbital with a single electron. Here we have only 3 orbital with a single electron. So when 5 chlorine atoms are approaching, there will be a jumping of an electron from 3s into d orbital, empty d orbital. So configuration becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1, 3px1, 3py1, 3pz1, 3dz2 1. So we have empty orbital, d orbital. There are 5 types of d orbital: dxy, dyz, dzx, dx2 - y2, dz2. 5 type of d orbitals available. So one electron is jumped from 3s into 3dz2 to have 5 equal bond length. For 5 covalent bond, bond length should be equal in a molecule, so that direct overlapping is not possible. Instead of that, intermixing of atomic orbitals of same atom phosphorus takes place. So totally here 5 atomic orbitals are intermixing together to produce 5 sp3d hybridized orbitals. So all these hybridized orbitals are having single electron. Then these sp3d hybridized orbital of phosphorus will overlap with atomic orbital of chlorine. It forms 5 covalent bond. Five covalent bonds can be easily formed. For chlorine, outermost orbital is 3pz with a single electron, isn't it? For chlorine, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3px2, 3py2, 3pz1. So this is the only orbital in chlorine with a single electron. This will involve in overlapping with sp3d hybridized orbital of phosphorus. Take phosphorus, 5 hybridized orbital has single electrons for overlapping, and each chlorine has 3pz orbital, isn't it? For each chlorine, the valence orbital is 3pz. And each orbital has a single electron, 3pz orbital. So direct overlapping between the sp3d hybridized orbital. So this is 5 sp3 hybridized orbital structure of phosphorus. Sp3d hybridized orbital of phosphorus will overlap with 3pz orbital of chlorine. So there are 5 covalent bonds between the phosphorus and the chlorine. So this will have two type of bond angle. So here 120 degree and 90 degree. So this is trigonal bipyramidal. So the geometry is trigonal bipyramidal. Okay, phosphorus pentachloride has sp3d hybridization. next sp3d2 hybridization example sulfur hexafluoride it takes sulfur atomic number 16 ground state configuration 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3px2 3py1 3pz1 So 6 fluorine atoms are going to make 6 covalent bond. We need 6 orbital with a single electron so that electrons are jumped from one orbital into another orbital. So excited state configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1, 3px1, 3py1, 3pz1, 3dz2 1. 3d(x²-y²)1. So one electron is jumped from 3s orbital into 3dz² isn't it? One electron from 3s orbital is jumped into 3dz² orbital, and one more electron from 3px orbital is jumped into 3dx²-y². So two electrons are jumped into d orbital. So totally we have 6 atomic orbital with a single electron. 3s, 3px, 3py, 3pz, 3dz², 3dx²-y². So one electron from 3s and 3pz jumped into empty d orbitals. So we have 6 atomic orbitals with a single electron. So all these are intermixing together. 6 atomic orbitals intermixing together to produce 6 sp3d hybridized orbital. So each sp3d hybridized orbital has a single electron. So all the 6 sp3d2 hybridized orbital has a single electron. So 6 fluorine atoms can overlap with 6 sp3d2 hybridized orbital to form 6 covalent bonds. What about overlapping orbital of fluorine? As we said already, 1s2, 2s2, 2px2, 2py2, 2pz1. So this is the only orbital with single electron. This will involve in overlapping with sp3d2 hybridized orbital of central atom sulfur. So this is the central atom sulfur. This is 6 sp3d2 hybridized orbital with single electron. Next, overlapping 2pz. So this, so all these are 2pz orbitals. So 6 fluorine atoms will combine with central atom sulfur . Each 2pz orbital of fluorine has a single electron, so head on overlapping will make 6 covalent bond, right? So this is sulfur hexafluoride structure. Sulfur is the central atom. So this is octahedral in nature. The geometry for a molecule with sp3d2 hybridization is having octahedral geometry. So due to hybridization, we get a polyatomic molecule with equal bond length. So hybridization is the process of intermixing of atomic orbitals of same atom with approximately equal energy to produce a new equivalent orbital called hybridized orbital, and the process is known as hybridization. So tomorrow we will discuss the structure of molecules like ethylene as well as acetylene. So they are the molecules with multiple bond. So up to sulfur hexafluoride we have discussed molecule with a single bond. Tomorrow we will discuss molecules with a double bond like ethylene as well as acetylene, and the molecular orbital theory will be discussed tomorrow. Okay, thank you.